So in this video, I am trying to explain some portions of the module 1 of web technology. So first, I explain the comparison between the World Wide Web and Internet. World Wide Web is actually a collection of information which is accessed via Internet. But Internet is actually a network of networks. Or we can say Internet is an infrastructure, while web is a service on the top of that infrastructure. Okay, then we can say Internet is a network of networks. That is, it is a collection of computers and other devices which is connected by networking devices. Web is actually a collection of softwares and protocols that is installed on the devices of Internet. Okay, so we can go to the next portion. What is browser and what is web server? So next I explain what is web browser, and after that I will explain what a web server is. So browsers are actually programs running on client machines. What it do is it requests documents provided by the servers. So the web pages are always in the web servers. These web servers, the browser will request the documents that is stored in the web server. Okay. After that, it will provide the result to the client machines. So browsers allow the users to browse the resources available on the servers. Or web browser is used to fetch the information resources from the web and display it on the user's devices. So with the help of URL is a uniform resource locator which contains information about the location of the resources in the Internet. Using that URL, web browser fetches the information from the web server and providing it to the users. Next I goes to web server. What a web server is. Web server, in somehow we can view web server as a software, or we can view the web server as a hardware. A web server, what it contains is, it contains a collection of web pages, or it sometimes it may contain one or more websites. A web server processes the incoming network request from the web browser and provide the HTML pages to the web browser. Okay, the primary function of every web server is to store the web page, process the web page, and deliver the web page to the client machine. The communication between the web client and web server takes place through a protocol called the HTTP protocol. The pages delivered by the web server are in the form of HTML documents. These HTML documents sometimes may contain images, style sheets, scripts, etc. So, we can go to the detail of web server. The web server has mainly two main directories. One we call it as a document root. The other is called the server root. The server root always stores the server related supporting softwares. The document root always contains the web pages in order to deliver for the clients. So all the control panel softwares for the working of the server is always stored in the server root. So once again I am explaining that in the case of web server there are two main directories. One we call it as document root, the other one is called the server root. The document root stores the web document for the users. The server has only direct access to this document root. Okay. The server root contains the server related working softwares, supporting softwares. Okay. Then the file stores directly in the documents are those available to the clients through top level URLs. The client do not access the document root directly in URL. Rather, the server maps the requested URL to the document root whose location is not known to the clients. Okay, suppose the document root is named topdocs and is stored in admin slash web directory. Okay, so it's making its address /admin/web/topdocs. A request for a file from a client with the URL www.tunias.com/this.html will cause the servers to search for the file with the file path admin/web/topdocs. So the server will direct the request to the appropriate server, maps the URL to the document root topdocs. Okay. Many servers allows the part of servable document collection to be outside the directory at the document root. This type of the secondary areas from which the documents is served is called the virtual trees. Sometimes the files with the different types of content such as images are stored outside the document root. Many servers can support more than one site on a computer, thus reducing the cost of each site and making their maintenance more convenient. Such secondary hosts are called virtual hosts. So, first I explain about virtual documentaries. Virtual documentaries means the servable documents are stored outside the document root directory. That is, we are creating a separate directory for serving the HTML request or HTTP request from the client machines. These secondary areas from which the documents can be served, we call it as virtual documentaries. What virtual host is that? Sometimes the servers are kept in many more than one site for the reducing the cost of each site, making their maintenance more convenient. Such secondary hosts are called virtual host. Okay, some servers can serve documents that are in the document root of other machines on the web. They are called proxy servers. Okay, next I explain some of the features of web servers. One of the main feature of web server is large data storage support. Every web server supports large storage space for storing data for multiple websites. So we can host multiple websites in single web server. Okay. So, large data storage support is one of the main feature of web server. Another is bandwidth controlling. Bandwidth controlling is to regulate the network traffic. So, it tries to minimize the excess network traffic. So, bandwidth of the data transmission is controlled by the web server. Another function is virtual hosting. Virtual hosting is a type of web hosting service in which a web server is used to host other software based web servers websites. So this feature is also supported by most of the web servers. Another type of feature of web server is server side web scripting. Most of the web servers enable the users to create dynamic web pages. We can only develop static web pages using HTMLs. So to make the web pages dynamic, most web servers supports popular scripting languages like Perl, Python, PHP, ASP, etc. Next advantage is hosting websites. We are using the web servers to place the websites in the web server in order to access by the people over the internet. So, web server play a significant role in web hosting services. Okay, these are some of the functions. So in the host, one of the feature hosting the website, it can store and sequence the website, provide web database access, serve the end user request. Okay, thank you. So in the next video, I will explain the URL and HTTP.